We're coming to you live from the Infosys headquarters in Bangalore, and joining me is the top management of Infosys, is Shibu Lal, CEO of Infosys, also joining us. Sanjay Purohit, Senior Vice President. Shibu, I'll start with you. It's been a good quarter, but Infosys also has had a challenging year in 2012 when it was the worst performing stock. Does this performance indicate that perhaps the worst is behind you and this is a sign of a turnaround?
So let me start with an overview of Q3. And we have performed well in Q3. We grew by 6.3%, 4.2% not including Lodestone. Our EPS is $0.076.
Sure.
And our growth this quarter has been actually broad-based. We have added 53 new clients. Our growth has been broad-based. Our offerings have all done well. In fact, we have 8 large deal wins in business and IT operations with $700 million of TCV. Consulting grew by 15%. And products and platform, we have added another $100 million of TCV.
Hmm.
Now, in the middle of the quarter, we have seen some challenges. And we have mitigated them. We have mitigated them with hard work and commitment of our employees.
Hmm.
In my mind, this is a reflection of the execution of the strategies over the last couple of quarters.
Hmm.
If you look at last quarter, we had 8 transformational wins and the revenue of that has come into Q3.
Mm.
So in my mind, this quarter is a result of the strategic execution over the last couple of quarters and our people's hard work and commitment. Now, it is important to note that the environment has really not changed.
Mm.
Right? The US environment is still unstable. The Europe is still going through the physical issues they are dealing with. That does impact our clients' confidence in making long-term decisions. It creates delays in decision making, as well as sometimes in deal ramp ups. So we remain cautiously optimistic. We have maintained our guidance for the year at 5%,
sure,
which implies a growth of 2.7% next quarter.
Hmm.
So we are cautiously optimistic.
But if you look at fiscal 14 at this point in time, Shibu, would you say that you would perhaps settle to a lower trajectory of revenue growth?
So actually, it is too early to talk about fiscal 14 because our clients' budgets are yet to get closed. They will close sometime in February. Early indication is that it will be flat or marginally down. But I believe that the interest in us, interest in our kind of work, will continue to be pretty strong, especially in managed services, offshoring, products and platform.
Mm.
Because when you have tremendous cost pressure, managed services is a way for us, for our clients to actually manage their cost. Products and platform is a way for them to actually convert their fixed cost to variable cost. Right? It allows less capital cost and more operating cost. So we clearly believe that while the budgets will be flat or marginally down, the interest in our kind of work will continue to be pretty strong.
People in the street say that Infosys has a margin fixation. What is your outlook on profitability? Do you expect to perhaps get into a band which is maybe lower but more realistic to achieve?
Actually, Infosys has very strong aspirations.
Okay.
I think that's the right thing to say.
Okay,
our aspiration always has been to have above industry growth rate and one of the leading margins.
Mm.
Now, everything which we have done, the strategies which we have put in place are meant to meet our aspirations.
Sure.
Right? And in the past, our strategies have allowed us to meet our aspirations. So in the long term, I clearly believe that, so when we talk about products and platform, for example, the average revenue productivity in that space should be at least double our average over a period of time, maybe 2 to 3 years. Consulting and system integration is higher revenue productivity. In business and IT operations, we can drive efficiency and productivity. So we are not changing our aspiration. Our aspiration is to have one of the leading margins.
Sure. Sanjay, on products and platforms, what is the sense that you get when you talk to clients? Are things getting better? Is decision making getting delayed? Have there been instances of projects getting delayed?
Actually, if you look at the overall products and platforms space, the momentum is sustained because today as we speak, we have a cumulative total contract value of about $600 million. At the same time, we're working with more than 70 customers in this area. And this is excluding Finacle. Finacle has been a long-standing, stable product, which is doing extremely well. Today, it's working with almost 150 customers across the world, continues to grow, is regarded as a long-term leader. And so if you look at the relatively early stage offerings, which are the production platforms which you launch now, momentum is very healthy, get to $600 million. If you look at the stable, the growth is also very healthy. And we are seeing a very, very good confidence and uptake in what the clients are looking at and finding our innovations are relevant. And so if you look at what all we have put together and taken to market, they're very relevant and very scalable. And I think so that gives us the confidence that we are progressing in the right direction at a very good velocity in this area.
Shubhu, a word on pricing as well. You've had a fairly stiff pricing policy. Have you made it a little more flexible? Has that yielded results?
So we have always looked at pricing as a portfolio. In a strategic account, in a strategic deal, we will show flexibility in pricing. But the important thing is to make sure that the pricing is managed as a portfolio. So there are certain areas in our business which are coming under pricing pressure, some of the traditional areas. That is why we are focused on actually increasing our presence in the other areas.
Sorry, when you mean traditional areas, you mean BFSI?
So for example, no, not BFSI. So for example, if you look at application maintenance, which has been a traditional area for us, it's more price sensitive compared with a business transformation program in consulting and system integration or a platform play in a space, because platform play is very different pricing, right? The pricing is transaction-based, it's not effort-based in products and platform space. So while some of the areas are becoming price-sensitive, our approach is to create a balanced portfolio which can actually counter that by having areas which are of high value or by having areas which are of a different pricing model. So, while the 1.8% is quarter-on-quarter, I wouldn't call it secular.
Sure.
I expect the pricing to be stable. I expect some areas to be under pricing pressure. So our strategy has to be to balance the portfolio so that we can actually have a stable pricing environment.
You've always said that Infosys is comfortable with about 76 to 80% utilization levels. What is the sense that you're getting? Would you have to revise your hiring plans as you go ahead? Would you be deferring campus if things look as challenging as they are today?
Actually, we have done some of it, so there's no doubt, right? Because, for example, this year we have only given 6,000 hiring plans. The excess capacity has to be used. Our utilization today is about 71%, whereas our optimum is about 78%. So we still have an additional bench of about 7 to 8%. Now I see it as an opportunity, because if the deals flow continues and we have opportunity to grow, this can be utilized. It will also be a margin accretive thing, right? Because by carrying that 7 to 8%, I have a cost impact of probably about 1 to 1.5%, plus a opportunity loss of another 2.5%. So it's a 3 to 4% margin loss because of that additional bench of 7 to 8%. So we have already made changes. Our plan evolves continuously, right? So we have already made some of the changes required for next year. We are preparing for next year. We have done some, we have looked at all our cost structures. We have looked at the recruitment requirements. Some of that already has been done.